This video covers some tips to help you build constructs with Golden Gate assembly. Tip 1. Plan carefully. With Golden Gate assembly, you are attempting to assemble many DNA fragments in a large, frequently complex construct. The type 2S sites must be in the region to be excised on your vector and be outward facing. It is also crucial to ensure no extra type 2S sites exist on your plasmid. For example, if you are working with BSA1, then there should just be 2 BSA1 sites on your destination vector in the correct location. To complement the orientation of your vector, the type 2S sites for your inserts must be inward facing. In addition, your inserts cannot contain internal recognition sites for the enzyme you are using. To ensure the sequences you are combining are functional after your cloning reaction, you need to be sure the translated product is in frame and accurate. SnapGene can simulate your assembled clone and verify that the predicted protein is correct. Tip 2. Optimize ligation. Golden Gate cloning depends on both your type 2S restriction enzyme and ligase being active in the same reaction. Standard type 2S restriction enzymes are active in ligase buffer, allowing for the one-step, one-pot reaction mixture. Remember, T4 DNA ligase activity requires soluble ATP. Therefore, as with any ligation, be sure that ATP is included in the reaction buffer and fully dissolved. In addition, if you have flexibility in designing your fusion sequences, include one or more GCs to improve the stability of the 4 base pair overhang. SnapGene can also help you choose suitable 4 base pair overhangs for your experiment. Tip 3. Larger numbers of inserts require different considerations. Plasmid size guidelines for successful transformation and growth in E. coli also apply to Golden Gate cloning. Ideally, the completed product should be less than 12 kb. Larger assemblies can be created, but may need additional screening of colonies to find a correctly assembled product. For assemblies of greater than 10 fragments, and assemblies where you want the highest assembly yields and transformation levels, cycle the temperature steps for 5 to 10 minutes. Tip 4. Screen for candidate clones. Ideal circumstances do not always lead to ideal outcomes. Luckily, the Golden Gate system includes a failsafe to screen for candidate clones. Depending on your destination vector, you may be able to perform a blue-white screen to determine the presence of LacZ in your colonies, with your intact vector growing blue colonies and candidate clones growing white. If you use a destination vector that includes the CCDB suicide gene, then bacteria containing intact destination vector will not be able to grow. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.